crash that could save you thousands? Our harsh weather and just plain age can cause cracks that will allow moisture to do a lot of damage if left unchecked. DC's cost-effective seamless roof coating can bring your RV roof back to life. Whether up on the roof or down on the ground, DC's RV Center has you covered year-round. DC's RV Center, yeah! DC's RV Center. We provide everything but your destination.
And welcome back this morning. One pair of mice can produce 200 offspring in 4 months. Ooh, which is why Home Team Pest Defense recommends checking your home or your office for signs of rodents and trying to fix that problem. And joining us this morning is Kevin Curry and Beth Binger from the Home Team Pest Defense with more on this. Thank you so much both for coming in.
Thank you, Katie, for having us.
Of course, happy to have you here.
Oh, and we have lots of fun statistics for you, just like that one.
Yeah, I mean, that's not fun. I don't call that fun. But let's talk about rodents specifically. I mean, it is this time of year where they're coming in from outside to try to stay warm.
Yeah, no kidding. And people think that they can just walk in and crawl in. Actually, a rat can jump 3 feet from a standing position. So
wow.
A rat can jump this high. So you really have to be thoughtful about how you kind of protect your home.
Right, exactly. You need to cut away the branches away from your home, because what they'll do is they'll crawl up that tree, jump from the branch onto your roof, and that's the first activity that they have to try to get into your home.
And many house mice can get in through a hole that's smaller than a dime?
Exactly. Yeah. What a mouse can actually enter your home in an opening the size of a dime, whereas a rat can actually enter a home with an opening the size of a quarter.
Oh, wow. Okay. So it's important to keep those closed, and it's hard to find those because, I mean, unless you're on the ground in your home, on top of your home, it's really hard to find all those nooks and crannies.
While it's important to go ahead and eliminate the problem that you're having, if you don't take care of the reasons why those pests got into your home in the first place, you're just going to have a reoccurring event over and over again.
Let's talk about food, because you brought this.
Go ahead. Well, I was going to say, it is easy to protect. If you walk around the outside of your house, if you can cover up those holes with materials like this, screens, and then Kevin's, too, got some steel wool and a really good product to help plug those holes. So that's kind of really the first step is, keeping them out. And it's not that tough if you know the right materials and you know the right way to go about it.
And you know how to do it. But I want to talk about this oatmeal, because a lot of problems come from food in the home.
Of course. And odors that you don't even think about that emit. And, of course, a rat or a mouse can just chew through this cardboard. They love this kind of stuff. So what you want to do is keep all of your food in Ziploc bags.
Yes.
So keep it in the Ziploc bag. It cuts down on the odor, and it keeps the mouse and rats from chewing through that.
Which is very important.
Not quite as convenient, but you'll be happier in the long run.
Oh, it's very convenient when you don't have those little black bugs or droppings in your food. It's extremely convenient, which I've dealt with before. It's not pretty. Kiyoshi's been talking about all morning long, and I know a lot of people have been talking about lately, especially this summer and the fall, is the fly problem in Bakersfield and Kern County. They sell in a lot of the home improvement stores is those bags of water. I've bought those before. They don't really work. A lot of people have said there's no solution, just deal with the flies. Is there a solution?
The solution that works best is sanitation. The reason that most people have flies is because they're not trying to tell people that they're not living clean. But again, areas where your trash cans are kept, they need to be scrubbed out on a regular basis. So as the trash comes to be picked up, take that time to go ahead and scrub out those trash cans, and also to scrub out the areas where you keep those trash cans, because that will cut down a great deal on any type of fly activity.
Yeah, definitely.
And we have a big fly problem here, and also the farms contribute that too. So there's some ways that there's no way to really get rid of them, because we have such large farmlands here. Well, thank you both so much for coming in this morning. Good advice this morning, and I know unfortunately it's that time of year where the critters all come out, and this is shocking that they can jump this high. Just take a look at that. That's pretty high.
They're pretty aerobatic. Yes.
Yeah. Shocking and scary all this morning for you. Thank you both so much
for coming in. Thanks for having us.
We'll be right back after this.
Sounds good.
Responsibility. We all have it. For some, it's a job or caring for a loved one. For Zach Scribner, it's ensuring his children will grow up without crushing debt and high taxes because government overspent.
Right now, Kern County's government is in a crisis because politicians have made promises that the taxpayers cannot afford. As supervisor, I'll make the tough calls, balance the budget, and cut waste.
Zach's represented us well on the City Council, Water Board, and Highway Commission, fighting to protect taxpayers. We can trust Zach Scribner for supervisor.
Jim Costa has let us down again. He voted against turning on the Delta pumps to bring us more water 3 times. And now he has the nerve to say that I'm against water? I'm Annie Bydak, and I'm running for Congress because it's time for a change. Jim Costa's failures have cost us dearly, bankrupting businesses and putting thousands of people out of work.